He gets a drum and a drum. He By that, we're making a TV show about first thing you see is a sign, and it says, it's never too late to live happily ever after. Okay? So that's what this song is all about. And so I wrote this because Rachel came into my life and changed my, made my world go upside down, I can tell you. And so this is her song, I really like it. It's called It's Never Too Late.
Thank you.
much fear of sin.
A lot of people ask me about what inspires me to write. You know, that song I just played you, I wrote back in 1994, and I wrote it in the back of a taxi in a bit of a hurry because it was my wedding anniversary and I forgot it. And so I wrote that song for my ex-wife. She's my ex-wife now. I wrote that song in the back of the taxi, and I had the idea on a plane flight. And when I realized that it was my wedding anniversary, and I hadn't called, or I was in the middle of a tour, and I realized, oh, I better send her a song. So that little love song came out of sheer desperation, ladies and gentlemen, and that was what inspired that. But, you know, I get inspired by a lot of different things. And as a writer, you really need to be inspired all the time. You know? I try to find new ways of being inspired. But the thing that inspires me most, of course, is life itself. People I meet, stories I hear. Everybody has a story. And it's always interesting to hear their story. And movies. Movies are a great source of inspiration for me too. And I want to play you a song that I wrote after I watched a film called The Bridge of Spies. It's a great Steven Spielberg film. And Steven Spielberg is one of the great storytellers of this last 50 years. What a brilliant filmmaker and storyteller he is. But in this movie, The Bridge of Spies, there was a scene in it where we saw how the Germans built the wall around in Berlin. And we saw how quickly that happened. And of course you didn't hear about that stuff. And as I left the cinema, I started thinking about this couple who lived right where they built the wall. And the husband went out early in the morning to go to work. And they built the wall and he couldn't come back. And he was stuck on the other side. And so his wife didn't know what was going on with him. They couldn't communicate. There were no mobile phones back in the 30s and 40s. And I just imagined her waiting and waiting, wondering what was going on. And so this is a piece of music that came to me. And because a songwriter waits for ideas. You can't force it. You know, I remember James Taylor, a great songwriter, saying that sometimes he's quiet and just sitting and waiting for something to come to him for 3 days before anything happens. He said sometimes you just have to wait. And that's true. You cannot force music. It has to flow through you and come to you in a natural way. And that's exactly what happened with this song. And I'd like to play it for you. It's called Ava Waits.
Thank you.
Fisher and everyone. And in this song, I play a lot of what we call harmonics on the guitar. Some people call it flageolets. And I think that's a French term, I'm not sure. It sounds French to me.
Flageolets. Tony,
this is really difficult. People ask me, is it hard to do? Well, did you ever try to put toothpaste back in the tube? Think about that. But here it is, Michelle. I'm going to play one more piece for you, and then we're going to take a real short break so you can whiz out and do what you need to do. And then we're going to come back and play the second set for you. So this is Somewhere Over the Rainbow.
Thank you. Vegas Country. Vegas Country.